Hello fam, this is Ajita back with another video. So if you haven't already done it, please subscribe and click the bell icon to get the notifications. Thanks in advance. So today we'll be learning cream painting with a palette knife. This is what we are going to do. So let's get started now. So let's start with frosting the crumb coated cake. As usual, first the tops, then the sides. If you want a detailed video of this, you should check out my whipped cream basics and whipped cream round cake sharp edges videos to know how it's done in detail. But this is a quick process video. Now once happy with the finish, now take any sharp edge tool and mark the guides. Right now I'm doing a wrap, so I'm doing in circles and marking few stems here and there wherever I want the leaves to come out of the wrap. I'm going to use 3 tones of green here. Then I have a lovely orange with a round nozzle to pipe flowers. Then I have taken palette or painter's knife. For this we'll be using a medium peak consistency of the cream. Now let's see how to load our palette knife or painter's knife. So first we'll start spreading our cream in thin layer about 1/6 of an inch. And by spreading we are also removing the air bubbles and smoothing it out. And once it's smooth as you want it to be, then you will start loading your palette knife just by cutting through the cream and lifting a little on either sides of it and then removing any excess, and it should look like that. Now let's use this on the cake. So while placing the leaves on the cake, you just need to press it down a little, and if necessary you can wiggle it so that you don't disturb the top of the cake, and it should be in place. Now you repeat the same process to get more leaves in whatever angle you want and whatever shape you want. You can go ahead and make those leaves. If you want smaller leaves, then only pick a little on the top edge of your palette knife. If you want bigger leaves, you can go further into the knife and have a lot of cream on your palette knife and get bigger leaves. Make sure to clean your palette knife now and then so that there is not a lot of excess cream that will start spreading onto your cake where you don't want it. Since I'm happy with the leaves of one tone, I'm now shifting to a darker tone and I'm making bigger leaves now because most of the big leaves are darker in shade. Placement of the leaves and the way you make them is up to you. Now with a piping bag with small opening, I'll be piping the stems for this wrap. Once I'm happy, it's now time for flowers. I'm just doing a simple flower. I'm just piping teardrop shapes, 3 teardrop shapes to be precise, at one place to make a flower. Some places maybe buds, like a single teardrop here and there. That's all. After this, if you want, you can add some borders, you can add message in the center, add any sugar pearls as you like, adorn it, and that's it. We are done. So hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. I'll be back soon with more content. Thank you. Bye-bye.